This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today we're going to talk about split-level VPN and some of the risks regarding it. Windows patching is coming up, and it's impactful during the best of times, and during this time of remote working even more so. Many of you have home computers or corporate laptops that are off the normal network connections and remoting in, and you're probably concerned like me of virtual private networks and remote desktop connections being saturated with those Windows updates and those Office 365 click-to-run updates. Now remember, you can set up what's called split-level VPN so that those management items that can go over a normal Windows update connection do not go through your VPN connection. Microsoft released a blog post about how to do this. And in addition, as part of their Office 365 network onboarding tool, they've now included additional testing for the split level. You go to the site, put in your tenant name, click to run the test, and it will actually tell you that you probably need some .NET in order to install it. In order to run the advanced test that will test your split level, you'll have to do an installation of .NET Core. You'll want .NET Core 3.1, and you'll go ahead and install it. Once you have the .NET Core installed, it will go ahead and run the tests and come back with results. In my personal test here, I'm not using a VPN, but as you can see, they've now included a VPN split tunnel configuration and let you know if you've got it set up correctly. Often when I hear split tunnel talked about, I see a near religious argument over the use of split tunnel VPNs. Some will argue they provide the ability to place the network traffic that is used for maintenance, such as Windows updating, installation of click-to-run Office 365, over the user's local connection without introducing more risk. Others say that unless you have all of the traffic that's intended for the corporation to go through that network VPN, you can't inspect the traffic and thus you can't keep the firm secured. The concern over the security of VPN comes down to how you've connected the client or the workstation to the network. If you connect a remote client to your network using virtual private networking and do not take the time to limit or restrict the client workstation, an infected machine can introduce risks and malware to your network. But there's ways to limit this risk. Often you can look to your firewall vendor that provides the VPN software to see if they also determine health risks to the organization. Look to your endpoint management solution to see if they also provide tools as well. Others argue that anytime you connect any workstation at all to your corporate network, you need to ensure that the machine is patched to a certain level, has up-to-date antivirus definitions, and follows a series of guidelines for health that your corporate mandate requires. Currently, we're kind of in a transition phase between network access protection, which was used for Windows 7, and the use of Intune or other tools for Windows 10. Intune can be used to check for BitLocker, code integrity, early launch anti-malware, which is only applying to PCs, secure boot, and other health conditions. Go into Intune and create a policy. The platform is Windows 10 and later, and then go through the different device health settings that you can set. You can require BitLocker, require secure boot, require code integrity. What that means is code integrity has to be enabled on the device so that any drivers or any applications have to be code signed. Device properties, you can configure a minimum operating system and what valid operating system builds are allowed to be used in the network. You can require device compliance from Configuration Manager, and then you can choose different security systems settings, such as encryption, firewall, trusted platform module, antivirus, anti-spyware. If Defender anti-malware is your preferred setting, require that. You can set a minimum version of anti-malware. You can make sure that security intelligence is up to date. You can require real-time protection. If you subscribe to Microsoft Defender ATP, you can require that the device be at or under the machine risk score. So you can set that the client has a clear security configuration, meaning that it doesn't have any risks to the organization. There are third-party tools that do similar kinds of activities. Look to security modules such as Carbon Black Endpoint Response, OSEC, or even Malwarebytes with suspicious activity modules. All of these can be adjusted to work with split tunnel setups in order to properly secure the network. Now, if you're in a situation where due to shortages of corporate laptops, you've had to resort to using home computers to provide hardware for remote working, you may want to instead set up a remote desktop system where the users remote into a virtual desktop setting and don't use corporate assets. Bottom line, should you be concerned about split-level tunnel VPN? Absolutely, but you should be just as concerned about any resource connecting to your network. Ensure you have the ability to review the traffic and be able to react to any threatening traffic coming into your network, especially now more than ever. As always, check out the resources on IDG Tech Talk for the latest on COVID-19 and what technology is doing to help you today. Until next time, stay safe, stay well. This is Susan Bradley for COS Online.